Southlake, how do they find a way to win without their top scorer?
Well, it's a devastating blow. Not only a top scorer, top playmaker, and the man that had the swagger for the Gales, but St. Mary's still a very capable team because of a terrific tandem down low, led by Omar Sam Hanna, a double-double man, a rugged player, and Diamond Simpson, silky smooth, and features the mid-range, and dominates the glass, an all-time leading rebounder for the Gales. And then for Gonzaga, on the flip side, it's about how they respond from the thumping they took in the hands of the Memphis Tigers out of Spokane.
Unbelievable. I've had a lot of trouble scoring in that one. A look at Star Watch. You talked about Simpson. He's a lockdown defender.
And Matt Bolden, such a well-rounded player.
Well, Matt Bolden can see and feel the game. Exceptional court sense and savvy. And we talked about Diamond Simpson, the greatest rebounder in school history, putting up big numbers.
To the lineups now for Gonzaga. They get four men in double figures. Bolden, Heitfeld, Day, and Gray. But Jeremy Pargo was WCC Player of the Year last year for St. Mary's. Omar Samhan joins Simpson as a double-double threat. And in Hughes, O'Leary, and Hunter, somebody else has to put the ball in the bucket tonight if they're going to knock off Gonzaga. Ready to get started. The Zags in the road blues. St. Mary's in the home whites. The place all sold out, and St. Mary's will have their first crack at it this evening.
Important that St. Mary's gets off to a good start here to get the Gale force, the student section here at St. Mary's, in full effect. And just at a point or stage of the season without Patty Mills where they need to get the wind back in the sails. And maybe the Gale force will help with that.
Walker into the corner wearing a Mohawk look for the Gale. Shot clock is already down to 7. Out front, Wayne Hunter. Hunter looking inside, dumping off for Samhan. They're going to turn it over.
Well, poor position there on the attempted catch by Samhan, and an ill-advised pass as well. Nowhere to go on the baseline.
Gonzaga coming in 17-5. St. Mary's, they are perfect here at home at 9-0, but they have suddenly lost 4 games, 3 of the last 4. Patty Mills is going to join us here courtside a bit later. Gray is on target for the first 3-pointer of the contest.
A good start for the Zags. Gray, a catch and shoot off the down screen. And talking to Mark Few, he said Memphis was the best defensive team they faced all year. And keep in mind, the Zags played UConn earlier this year. So high praise for John Calipari's team.
They may have caught Memphis on Memphis' best night possible. They played a near-perfect game. Samhan on the back down. They floated up there. A lot of iron. Tipped away and controlled by Gonzaga. The Zags were being hailed as a Final Four type of team back in December. On a hard move, Day trying to get it to go but can't. That'll roll away. Pull up shot here by Hunter. He'll drop in the 3 and quickly tie it up. Noted as a strong defender, but he can give you some offense. Heitfeld with his first touch, trying to dish off for Gray. Loose ball will spit out of bounds, and Gonzaga will keep it. But Hunter with a terrific release on a jump shot. Mark Few in his 10th year at Gonzaga, and one of the great gentlemen in college sports. He's been involved in this Gonzaga success story from the very beginning, first as an assistant. Here's Bolden, leaves it short, his first jump shot of the evening. Hunter trying to strike again. Why not? A quick hot hand for Wayne Hunter.
Well, back to back. The Zags got to get back with a sense of urgency and transition. The Gales taking advantage of the scattered floor opportunities.
Gray dumping down for Heitfeld. The foul. He'll go to the line. Samhan with the personal. But Hunter getting it going quickly for the Gales.
Well, a good look off the rebound. Look up the floor. The pass is quicker than the bounce in advancing the ball. And good lift in rhythm by Hunter on his back-to-back 3 balls.
And we kind of look at a dapper Patty Mills on the sideline. We're in a red tie, all decked out. Everything works except for the cast.
Well, if you're Mark Few in particular, it's heartbreaking to see Patty Mills, the man with the swagger, the leader, the extension of Coach Few on this floor. Now an assistant coach, he's taken on the responsibilities.
Opening minutes here at St. Mary's.
Actually, Dave, Mark Few probably doesn't mind seeing him on the bench.
It's
Randy Bennett that's heartbroken. Mark Few's quite pleased.
Actually, he's delighted. Well, not with the fact that he's injured. He doesn't want to see a young man hurt, I'm sure. Oh, the quick hands here by Pargo out in front. He'll lay it in. the reigning West Coast Conference Player of the Year with the quick hands.
Well, it's important that the Gonzaga perimeter players step up. They had a quiet afternoon or evening against the Memphis Tigers. Expect them to respond here.
O'Connell, the foul line inside, knocks down two. Mickey O'Connell, a sophomore out of Mesa, Arizona.
Well, O'Connell wisely taking that mid-range jumper. Breakneck pace here early. The travel on Fargo is forcing the action.
Fargo will give it back. There's Randy Bennett, his eighth season for St. Mary's. He continues to be mentioned for big school jobs like Arizona. But Bennett has worked wonders here in Northern California. 25 wins, a trip to the NCAA tournament a season ago, and maybe followed by another. Corner jump shot, Simpson not there for him. Rebound comes to Pargo, and here come the Zags on the attack. Bolden handles the ball so well, does so many things well. Day, too strong. Rebound picked off by Simpson. Well, he's approaching 1,000 rebounds, by the way.
Both teams putting the pedal to the metal, playing at a high octane pace. I'd expect to see St. Mary's go high-low. Simpson to Samhan. Can't finish.
Does not convert, but on your point, that's exactly what they went to.
Yeah, I think they need to get the big fellas involved. That's the strength or the heart of their offense.
Day draws the double team in the corner, and it knocks away from him out of his hands. And out of bounds off of Gonzaga. The Bulldogs with 10 consecutive trips to the NCAA tournament, 11 straight 20-win seasons, and a perfect 8-0 in the West Coast Conference. But St. Mary's trying to knock them off here tonight. And Day, maybe some frustration back to the previous play, reaches out and commits a rather silly foul well away from the basket.
Now, it's important not just offensively to exhibit shot selection or shot discipline, but defensively it's equally as important that you demonstrate discipline. Stay down, move the feet, don't reach. You want to play with intensity, but also have the intelligent component as well.
Trying to tiptoe that line, Stephen Gray. 16:07 to go here in the first half.
But David, keep in mind the frustration level coming off that loss that Gonzaga had against Memphis. If you add up Austin Day, Bolden, Gray, and Pargo's numbers, combined only 15 points against the Tigers. And that speaks to the respect that Mark Few has for the Tigers' defense, but also cold shooting.
Simpson trying to drive around. There's Hunter. Shot clock at 12 now for St. Mary's. O'Connell with the dish. Inside Samhan, blocked away by Heitfeld as he slammed it. And on numbers, great job there on the fast break. Bolden and one. He'll go to the line. A perfectly run break for Gonzaga. It started with a great defense.
Well, defense creates offense. It's going to get the Zags out in the open court. And Heitfeld past weekend. But Ben Howland's team still making progress. A lot of young players, Jeremy Anderson, Malcolm Lee, Jeru Holiday, Drew Gordon. So that team still very capable when you add to the mix the experience of the final fours by Darren Collison and Josh Shipp and company.
Bolden just went over 1,000 points, and he completes the three-point play, and now whistle on the press. Foul against Gonzaga here. Stephen Gray reaching in. A hot start so far for Wayne Hunter of St. Mary's, but Gonzaga has the lead here. In the early going in Moraga, California's absolutely gorgeous campus at St. Mary's, one of the prettiest places you'll find in college sports.
And I love the small venues. That's part of the charm and the allure of the West Coast Conference. Some great little band boxes, little hornet's nests or snake pits, tough to play in for opposing teams. They're very intimate, fan-friendly. You like baseball venues like that. Wrigley Field, Fenway Park.
Absolutely adore them. O'Connell decides to spin and shoot high off the window. Won't fall. Tough rebound. Simpson right back up. He'll draw the foul. He is a
Golden State Warriors. Is actually getting married this weekend. Thomas Sherry, an author, a Renaissance man as well, a poet.
Now Diamond, the reigning West Coast Conference Defensive Player of the Year. Also all West Coast Conference first teamer. And he leads St. Mary's in career blocks. Already we've had four lead changes in the early going of this game. Heitfeld up top. Dropping it down low for Bolden. Bolden working on Hunter. Got airborne. Swoops the pass for Heitfeld, but he decides not to shoot it. That's going to be a 3-second violation because they dilly-dallied. First use of dilly-dally tonight.
Lollygagging, dilly-dallying. Good vernacular here early, OB. I think the Bay Area has inspired you. The architecture, the beauty, the bridges.
And I was going to say, you know, when you get in the Bay Area, you know you're going to get great restaurants in San Francisco. We did that up, and a little bit later, special treat for those of you who understand what great eating is all about. One look at me, you can tell I do. And we're going to get a look at Lav's favorite eating spots in San Francisco.
Yeah, some dining dandies. Dick Vitale has the rights to the diaper dandies.
Right,
but
right.
I've got the rights for dining dandies.
Ben Allen, the transfer from Indiana, gives off for O'Connell, and that one's all net. Well, Mickey O'Connell hits 39% from out there.
Well, and it's critical that the guards, O'Connell included, for St. Mary's, have some success on the perimeter. Get some confidence with Mills out.
Heitfeld, bottom iron, rolls off the tin. And here come the Gales. They're averaging 74 points a game, but without Patty Mills, they've really scuffled the score. Simpson using his body. He gets hit. Fouled by Ira Brown underneath. 13:54 left in the half. That's number two on Brown.
They need to find his stride, shooting the ball from the perimeter. And of course, Krabbenhoff and Landry, an impressive front line, and a young player, John Lur, who only improves with each practice and game. Badgers on the move.
Dimitri Goodson in and helping to run the point now for Mark Few. A mini 6-0 run for the Gales of St. Mary's. Goodson out of Spring, Texas. He also produced Josh Beckett of the Red Sox. Shot clock down to 13. Shot lofted up by Downs. Micah Downs not there. Nice return by Heitfeld. It will not fall. And St. Mary's comes up with a loose ball.
Got to finish that bunny if you're Heitfeld. His size, with his strength down low, an experienced player. Point blank range. Don't get many of those.
Gonzaga has dropped three of the last four they have played in this building.
Jags like to run those pick and pops, pick and rolls, go about the triangle basketball.
Simpson leaning into Downs. Tough shot, difficult angle. Slapped out by Gonzaga.
Well, you mentioned that tough shot. Once you've got the elbows down, the tonsils, highly contested, low percentage look, always better to keep your balance and kick it out. You can then reestablish and get a dump down again.
Well, Heitfeld will step out for a moment. St. Mary's to check in. Over the top to Hunter.
Late clock. Not sure if he's aware.
They loft it up there, but it will not drop. Simpson with the rebound. Went up, and that one blocked by Downs. But a whistle and a foul as well. I don't think they got Downs on that foul, did they? We'll give you another look at it. I think they did, actually. And he can't believe it. Mark Few can't believe it.
There's the long bomb. Simpson cleaning up the weak side, just trying to muscle his way through. Had the elbows out. Bolden took one to the chops. A no call. Feisty here early in the West Coast Conference.
Sure is.
In Moraga.
I'm glad we're up late for the entertainment. Simpson not a great foul shooter. At 62%, makes one of two. He's already gone to the line three times. That's an early trend for St. Mary's.
He's so active on the glass. He's quick enough, so slower, lumbersome post players have a tough time matching up with Simpson. If you play a smaller player on that speed, he can take you down low.
You're going to get the big Ben Allen with that personal foul. A little shove in the lane. 6'11 junior out of Melbourne, Australia. Just about every other name for St. Mary's will hail from someplace in Australia.
Well, Randy Bennett's done an excellent job, developed a pipeline of Australian players. He's found a way, David, is recruiting to find a couple sleepers and get a couple imports, international players, and build the team.
Oh, nice follow by Downs. We get up off the deck very quickly. The former Kansas transfer. Here's Hunter again. Oh, man, is he cooking.
Well, he likes that spot.
He has banged in three threes in the first half. This is a guy who averages 5 points a game. Randy Bennett told us yesterday in practice, I got to find somebody else to score the ball. Simpson with the theft. They've got numbers. A three-on-one. Back to him. Oh, great stop by Downs, but they got him for another foul.
Well, tough to see from this angle. Looked like it might have been a Spalding sandwich up high, all leather. Maybe there was some body or mid-air contact on that lob, but here's the strip by Simpson. Wisely going to give it up and try and get the ball back. A good lift or lob pass.
Ooh,
looked clean from that angle.
So Simpson back to the line again, where he is making a living here in the first 20 minutes. He leads the Gaels in career blocks. He's been an Iron Man, starting every game for St. Mary's over the last 3 years. Randy Bennett says he's a little bit under the radar nationally.
One of the best names in all of college basketball, Diamond Simpson.
St. Mary's battling for the rebound, but they'll turn it over on the line, and now it really does get chippy, and we're going to have a technical foul against St. Mary's here. Bennett wants to know why, but it started to get a little more violent than they're going to allow after the play.
Well, Dave Libby right on top of it.
Perhaps on Pargo. And they reacted very quickly to make sure it did not get out of hand.
There was a little scuffle right in front of us, Dave, at half court. Just chippy. It's February. Gonzaga a little frustrated coming off the loss to Memphis, where they take into the woodshed. And St. Mary's with their backs to the wall. A sense of urgency with the loss of Patty Mills and dropping three or four games. It's to be expected. A lot of adrenaline, testosterone in the house.
This is a quick step as it knocked away from him. And a great save by Simpson on the baseline. St. Mary's mishandles, however, and here comes Bolden. But the pace is relentless. In traffic, tipped up. No good. They'll get another crack at it as Goodson retrieved it right underneath the basket.
And neither team, Dave, offensively has established much of a rhythm. Haven't given themselves a chance because they've been playing in a hurry.
Another whistle and a foul here with 11:19 to go. Boy,
Huskies still have enough margin for error when you look at A.J. Price and Jeff Adrian down low, and Hasheem Tabeed, an X factor in all of college basketball at 7'3". And as a coach, you have to find a way to neutralize or offset a loss, an injury like that. That's why you're paid.
Down to the catch and shoot, barely glancing off that iron. By the way, moments ago, a double technical on Hughes and Goodson. So each side got hit.
Well, Dave Libby wanting to establish a tone in this game.
Pretty move there by Ian O'Leary, 6'7" senior. He's a real chemistry guy for them. Heitfeld gets banged underneath, shoved on his way up for the alley-oop. But back to that double technical, that little scrum at midcourt after this play.
I think just a little frustration. You see him jawing, chipping at one another, and there's Dave Libby. It jumps right in. Going to go with the double technical, and again, just establishing a little control before something like that can accelerate to elbows getting thrown or punches or a fight.
Heitfeld hits the first one. Omar Samhan just picked up his second foul. Heitfeld at 14.7 rebounds a game. The first game against St. Mary's, not a headline game for the senior. He had just 9 points and 5 rebounds. He looks like he's ready to step it up tonight.
He's a tough matchup, capable of getting it going from the perimeter. You know, a big man that can step away and big enough to take you down low as well.
O'Connell with a wild shot flying down the lane. Here's Pargo, who nearly jumped to the NBA after his junior season. You know, they bring him back, foul at the foul line.
And Dave, both these teams have not allowed, get some touches on the ball, give yourself a chance to go inside before you take a shot outside, give yourself a chance to get fouled or get a good look.
O'Connell with the foul to put Day at the line, and it's in and out. Both teams already in the bonus, and that's part of that herky-jerky nature you're talking about. No fluidity yet. Lots of fouls. Hughes off to O'Connell. He'll run the point.
And St. Mary's still searching for an identity without Patty Mills, losing their playmaker, shot maker, the player with the most confidence.
Hughes will fire. Left it well short. Out in front. They've got a man, Gray, in front of the field. He can't. convert, but Heitfeld underneath will be fouled as he went to crash the glass on the follow.
We're seeing some point blank range shots come up empty.
Ben Allen's second foul. Heitfeld 72% at the line. His career at Gonzaga has not been a smooth one. Stress fractures in his right foot, requiring two surgeries, also one in his left ankle, and of course his famous suspension for possession a couple of years ago. Trying to put up a strong senior season. And off the back of the iron. Under 10 minutes to go before halftime here at St. Mary's. And a blocking foul here on Austin Day. Second time he's committed that kind of a foul. Well, for one night, the stars and legends take the court together. It's the NBA All-Star Celebrity Game on ESPN Friday at 7 o'clock Eastern. Which you'll have another look at Dominique Wilkins and Clyde Drexler. They'll be taking part along with
build the ability there, a control tip with one hand. Made it look easy.
So far, St. Mary's hanging on to the lead against Gonzaga, but they also had the lead when they had Patty Mills at Spokane, and then he went down with the wrist injury, and they lost that game. Here's Ben Allen, too strong from the corner. Fargo controls the board, and we'll have Patty with us right here at courtside in just a couple of moments. Around and out on the three by Gray. A lid on the basket on both sides suddenly. After to the baseline, and he'll be fouled by Bolden.
And there is a lid on these rims, Dave, but part of the anemic shooting percentages by these teams is the fact their shot selection has been very poor. Not giving themselves a chance to get good looks. Just in a rush, in a hurry, many contested shots, quick shots. And Gonzaga shot 36% against Memphis, and part of that was the Tigers stifling defense. But also you go back and look at possessions where they forced the action.
Bolden, in fact, did not score in the first half of that game against Memphis. You mentioned it earlier, the top scorers was totally shut down. Mark Few said they dominated us in every phase of the game, talking about Memphis.
When John Calipari's dominating Conference USA the way Jerry Tarkanian and the Running Rebels used to in the old PCAA conference out west.
Sure, excellent comparison. And they're running the table again this year. Fargo, the point guard. Not a good pass. Well read by Ian O'Leary on the steal. St. Mary's with it, playing at home in front of a raucous crowd and leading it 22-17. Hunter, he's already buried three threes.
So difficult adjusting in mid-season when you lose your point guard, quarterback, playmaker.
That'll be goaltending. Heitfeld so active, but a little bit too much here.
Well, a good penetration, the shot fake, lifts the defender.
It's actually Micah Downs. So we have a timeout with 8:23 to go here. St. Mary's with a 24-17 lead over number 21 Gonzaga in the rematch in the West Coast Conference. Welcome back to St. Mary's in our Thursday night showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. It's Gonzaga and St. Mary's, part of Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco.
There's the Gale Force, the student section for St. Mary's. Full effect. Look at the body paint.
I spent all day looking for red and blue paint. No wonder I couldn't find any anywhere in downtown San Francisco.
You didn't go to the Haight-Ashbury.
Heitfeld has that knocked away. It'll be Zags basketball with 8:02 remaining in half number one. Gonzaga won the first meeting 69-62. Mills was only in the ballgame for part of that. And he took that seemingly innocent spill. He takes about 7 or 8 of those a game. A lot of fracturing that wrist. Bolden with a little fadeaway. And that drops in. Nice touch.
Well, there's Bolden using the size, the ability to put the ball on the floor, the bounce, and finish at mid-range. Bolden has that feel for the game. Great vision.
Commanding the ball down low, Diamond Simpson trying to get around Heichel. Shot clock at 10 for the Gales. O'Connell will back it out, but now has to rush it. 4 seconds to shoot and throws it away. On the defensive pressure, Pargo. He spins. Needs some help now. Here's Bolden to loft it up. He buries the three.
Well, a great decision by Pargo. Not forcing the action, instead reverse pivoting and fanning the ball back out on the perimeter to the trailing Matt Bolden. Great time to take that three ball.
Odd stack, Gonzaga with only 2 assists and fairly deep into the first half here.
The game has lacked any type of offensive rhythm.
O'Connell blocks out a play now for Randy Bennett and the 19-4 Gales. Shot clock again down to 4. Simpson has it knocked away from him. Shot clock down to 2 as it went out of bounds off of Gonzaga.
Thing for me that I need to focus on, but you know, lucky enough for me, you know, it doesn't take that long for me to get my conditioning back. So I think the main thing for me though is to make sure I still got my skills there, make sure I still got my touch. So, you know, hopefully when I do come back, you know, there's nothing missing.
Coach Bennett and the staff have mentioned how you smoothly made the transition into the role of an assistant coach in timeouts and during the flow of the game and taking players aside. Now, how has that been for you? Different perspective?
Yeah, look, I've taken this whole situation as a new challenge for me. And a lot of people say, you know, are you, you know, disappointed with the hand and with the team? I've taken it how it goes and, you know, making the most of my opportunities and now I'm still making sure I'm involved with the team.
Sam hand down low, but a whistle here.
To that, but I can tell you what, it was such a fun game to be involved in and it's such a great team, Gonzaga, but, you know, me there, me not there, you know, I'm sure the guys always give a 100% effort all the time and, you know, that's what happened at Gonzaga and they went down by 6.
Into the corner, Hunter, who's had the hot hand. Sam Hand has that one rolling in. He's shooting 57% from the field. But as your coach was telling us yesterday, Randy Bennett, he likes every shot.
Yeah, indeed. And Omar taking shots like that, he's a big part of the team. And if we can get it down low to him, you know, let him do what he does. And we have other people, you know, cutting off the post. And he's a good passer as well. So, yeah, he's a big part.
Patty, are you targeting?
You know, is what I can come back for.
Patty, recently you and Ben Allen, one of your partners from down under, spoke at Camino Pablo Elementary School to a third grade class. Actually, it was Ann Shreve's third grade class. And tell our viewers a little bit about what that experience was like.
Yeah, it was a great experience for me. You know, I love kids and I love, you know, getting the opportunity to go back and thank all the people that have given the amount of support for us. And it was a great opportunity to go and you know, read books to them and really get to know them. So it was a great opportunity.
Saw some kids with the flair for the artistry as well there. Some future Picassos or Van Goghs looking at that jersey.
Better penmanship than we've got, I can tell you that, some of these kids.
Yeah, they had great handwriting, actually.
Valentine's wishes for you, so you've got a lot of young fans and wishing you the best. Some of them were adorable. They were like, did you slip and trip on something? Did someone throw something underneath your feet? Great stuff. The kids just love you. Bolden outside here. We're tied at 27. Visiting with Patty Mills, the star of St. Mary's. As you can tell, a very humble young guy. St. Mary's on the attack now.
Yeah, it's also an important time for Australia and the Australian community all around. We've got the Victoria bushfires happening at the moment. So, you know, I'd like to take the time at the moment to send out condolences to the people in Victoria on behalf of the Australians here at St. Mary's, but also, you know, the whole St. Mary community and, you know, send out our wishes, best wishes for them, and hopefully they recover really well.
Simpson pulling in, returns another one. That one goes. Samhan has it stripped away from him. Goodson, the freshman, going 1-on-2, a nifty spin for the bucket. And Gonzaga has the lead. That hasn't been said much here in the first half, 29-27.
Well, the Zags on the run, and we're going to have to...
Here at St. Mary's, as Heitfeld has it outside the three. And Goodson will set it up.
Patty, we want to thank you for coming on. You got a bright future, not only at the next level of basketball, but someday as a broadcaster. You may be taking my job.
That was my goal coming in tonight. I hope to take Steve Lavin's job.
It was a pretty good audition, I'll tell you. Flying colors you passed with.
I know Mike Krzyzewski said about you when he was coaching the U.S. Olympic team that you burned for 20 in Beijing. He said, I'm just glad Mike Duke's team doesn't have to face Patty Mills because he's going to the NBA, and that'll be the next stop for you.
And I want to know where you get your threads. There is some sharp-looking GQ zapper.
Yeah, you know, when I'm not in my basketball uniform, I like to make sure I'm all sharp.
Patty, thanks so much for the visit. I'd shake your other hand, but we want that one to heal properly.
Left hand shake is what I'm learning.
Take care.
Ambidextrous. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
We'll be back at St. Mary's in just a moment. And the pace has really picked up here in Northern California on a Thursday night. Here at St. Mary's, Gonzaga has surged in front 31-30. They've been trailing Lab most of this first half.
Well, the Zags in the midst of a 21-12 run as they have moved out in front of St. Mary's. And Bolton starting to get the hot hand, which is vital.
He has 11, and in fact leads all scorers. Simpson deep into the corner. Diamond Simpson out of Hayward, California. O'Leary will back it out now. O'Connell directing traffic for the Gales. Trying to go to 10-0 here at home. They knew they were going to have their hands full here tonight, especially without very charming Patty Mills. We had a great visit with him.
Boy, is he polished?
Just a bit. Hunter draws the foul in the act of shooting the three.
Well, it's the same spot on the floor where he's been hot all night, dialing up the three balls.
So he will get three shots.
Well, and the cardinal rule here is don't foul a jump shooter.
And Dimitri Goodson, the freshman, did exactly that. His second. So three opportunities here. Hunter at 61% at the line, not his favorite spot, but looks good on the first one. They redshirted him last year.
Hunter stepping up, productive evening thus far. And if you're going to upset a team when you're down a player like Patty Mills, you're going to need some unexpected contributors. Sam Hand and Simpson, both double-double players on the front line for St. Mary's, but it's important that Hunter and some other players step up and join the party.
Another good one here in rivalry week on the West Coast between Gonzaga and St. Mary's. And he made all three. Already 13 points for Wayne Hunter. And that ties a career high.
If you're Randy Bennett, you have to explore, use the ingenuity of resourcefulness to find a way to generate points offensively, to get stops defensively. And you have to adjust when you don't have the speed, the quickness, the intelligence of a Patty Mills on the floor, no longer in the mix.
Heitfeld looked for the hook shot off his hand, but he got it back and flipped it up.
Soft touch there on the jump hook along the baseline. That's a tough angle.
On the second one, yeah. That qualified as a shot. The first one that rolled off his fingers. O'Leary zips the pass for Simpson. Very athletic attempt, and he'll draw the foul. He's been living at the foul line. Hit there by Ira Brown, a 6'4 senior. Rivalry week continues on ESPN on Saturday. And first at noontime Eastern, it'll be Georgetown and Syracuse. The Hoyas put a licking on the Orange in their first meeting, and then at 9 Eastern. Saturday night primetime, Ohio State against Wisconsin. Right now, are the Buckeyes in the NCAA tournament?
Well, if they could win their home games, finish above 500, they'd like to crawl back into the race. I think Michigan State in front now, favorable schedule. They do have two remaining games against Purdue, but I see the Spartans winning the Big Ten championship. They've got so much balance both inside and out. And Tom Izzo would like to get his first Big Ten title since 2001, a little 8-year drought here.
Even at 33, Heitfeld in the lane. Had to get creative with that shot because Simpson is such a good defender. Did not give him any ground. Yusef Smith kicks out for O'Connell.
Let's see if the Gales are wise enough to keep playing through the interior. Explore.
Smith will fire it up. Yeah.
Why not?
Senior out of the Bronx cashes in.
So much for feeding the post, playing inside out. Just launch a three.
Fire it up from 25.
Feeling it.
Four, and during the rematch between St. Mary's and Gonzaga, play has been tough and spirited. including a double technical and 19 fouls in the first half. The lead has changed hands on 9 different occasions. And Patty Mills, the Gale star, forces a bench with that wrist injury and then came on to take Lab's job. We had a great visit with Patty and a terrific first half. We're tied at 36. Thursday Night Showcase presented by T. Rowe Price. It is all part of Rivalry Week presented by Cisco. Back and forth we went. Both teams started to heat up, Lab, in the late stages of that first half.
Well, they did, and they did it in combination of ways. They got themselves to the foul line where they were 8 for 10, 4 of 6 from the three-point line, and most importantly, they pounded the ball down low. They outscored St. Mary's 14-2 in the a polished offensive player, uses his size in transition here to finish for an old-fashioned three-point play attempt, moving well without the ball, a little fade off that screen, and hits one from distance, and we take a look at our stat sheet.
Well, Bolden with 11, Heifel with 12 and 7, 14 points in the paint for Gonzaga. Simpson had 6, all of those at the line, also hit the glass hard as he had 6 first-half rebounds, and he is one under the magic number of 1,000 in his St. Mary's career. He is just a junior, by the way, out of Hayward, California. So ready for the second half. Gonzaga in the blue will have the basketball, and we are underway.
And a good delivery over the top there by Austin Day.
So Gonzaga with a quick strike to grab the lead. Most of the first half, it was St. Mary's in front. Down low, Sam Hamm. Kick up top for O'Connell. That's one, that one's going to be off that iron. Tried to save it into the bench, but can't. Nicky O'Connell is firing on the three. And back over to the Zags it goes here. Gonzaga undefeated in the West Coast Conference. They are 8-0. St. Mary's at 9-0 at home here at McKeon Pavilion. So something has to give. Fargo backing down on O'Connell, and that's going to roll in.
Well, and I like the adjustment here early. Mark Few probing a matchup, putting Fargo in the block. That's inversion, where you put the guard down low, a playmaker who can cause some problems, use his strength there, and take the bigs away from the basket. Let them deliver it.
O'Connell, the bad pass, picked off by Bolden. Should have shot that. Bolden down the lane, bowling in, and that's going to be an offensive foul. So wave that off. Coming right at you.
Well, Bolden picks up the charge. Looked as though the defender was sliding. And a little bit of acting there as well.
On O'Connell, but Bolden with the foul. See the turnovers, not a whole lot. Hunter, great pass underneath, but the stuff not there by Walker. And now the whistle and the foul. Great look on the high-low.
Well, here's that inversion. Take your big Austin Day, a skilled 6'10 sophomore who can throw it over the top. Fargo with a good release. Got the school term right in the 50s, military. Everyone had to get a schlitzy.
And you have to be careful how you say that. Stolen away here by Diamond Simpson, and he'll stuff it in. That lights up the crowd.
Well, good anticipation. Casual passes on the perimeter, picked off.
Outstanding defender now. Scramble on the deck. And a timeout for Gonzaga as they had possession with Heitfeld hitting that hardwood quite hard. We have got a timeout tied at 40 with 18:08 to play here at St. Mary's.
NCAA Women's Basketball Championship coming in March to ESPN.
What is hired by Steve Prefontaine, who went to Oregon, was an outstanding runner. But when you think through the years, these 5 players jump out at you. Not only did they have outstanding games, but unique dudes. A little like Mickey Dolan from the Monkees or the Beatles. More recently, Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Sure. You had Spicoli.
Sean Penn. Heitfeld will turn and fire and draw the foul on Omar Samhan at the personal, the 6'11 junior.
We're taking a look at some of the mops. Looks like they just rolled off the pillow.
Well, how about even Samhan? This is 2 years ago, Omar Samhan, and he's got a much tighter lip.
Well, like Samson, maybe the strength is in the mop top.
And the stars. Heitfeld connects.
So creative.
He can do anything in the barbershop these days.
It could be the frigid weather conditions as well. Something to do with the Northwest trying to stay warm.
Yep. You and I, on the other hand, just reach for the gel.
Although we both cut back.
A little bit, yeah.
Since Obama's election, trying to do our part.
Yes. Got to pitch in.
Oil prices. Green, Al Gore, be impressed. Environmentally sound.
The pull-up pop by Hunter. He was cooking in the first half. Simpson up and blocked. Heitfeld right in his face. A battle for it. Simpson wins it back and stuffs it down.
Boy, staying after it. A little tenacity. A nose for the ball. And then the ability to elevate. Go up the ladder and chin up on the rim.
Now 1,001 career rebounds for Diamond Simpson.
A little scissor action by Gonzaga. Put it in the best decision maker on the team, but bad there. Good anticipation. Look at the run out.
Yes, he lays it in. He wasn't exactly in stride for the slam.
Managed to gather himself and finish. The second time Gonzaga's been lazy. Not much velocity on those passes around the horn. And as a result, Simpson capitalizes.
And so active. Day underneath, not there for him.
Day has to be stronger with the ball. Got to get in the weight room and finish that, son.
Walker trying to take that baseline. Sealed off by Graber. Flips it up and contact. He'll go to the line for a three-point play.
Diamond Simpson laying in the weeds, Dave, like a cat. Here he's rebounding. Going to go to work inside with the flush, and then there he is. Like a cat pouncing on that pass, taking advantage of the soft perimeter passes, and then just taking it to the hole. A little tipsy-do off the glass, a little emotion.
Give a guy a little air time over his haircut, look what he does.
Yeah, he has a creative look, no doubt.
Stephen Gray picked up his second foul to put Walker to the line. And here come the Gales up by five. Way out to Bolden, the leaner. Finished by Heitfeld as he followed hard.
Good curl in the lane there by Bolden. But St. Mary's gets organized quickly here in transition for early offensive looks.
Same hand, yes, that mid-range jumper. Shoots it at such a high percentage.
A big wide body with skills. That international style of play both these teams employ. Big men that like to step away.
Bolden looking to make a move here. Zags has fallen by five. He drives to his right. Tough shot. He had too much momentum going off that window. Walker traveling in hard, and he is going to be hit and fouled with 15:39 to go. We have a timeout on the floor, and when we come back, a look at the WCC, glance at it. Sits the pass for Walker, but he can't complete it. He had a great look, too. Here's Downs. He decides not to shoot. Heitfeld will. He's had a good second half. He has 16, but can't get that one in.
Heitfeld rushed that shot. Didn't really get set or planted. Kind of quick shot the ball.
Same hand knocked away from him. It'll be St. Mary's ball. One thing about Heitfeld, he's playing with three fouls. And a ton of time remaining here, 14:46.
Well, and that's why St. Mary's would be wise to put some touches on the ball and explore. Throw, don't force the ball inside, but try and get a fourth foul and put Heitfeld on the bench.
Off the inbounds, Hunter. They go underneath Simpson. That's going to be an offensive foul. That's exactly what they do, and it was Heitfeld who hits the deck, but the foul goes.
He clearly just knocks over Heitfeld.
So the personal on Diamond Simpson. It'll be number two on him. 49-44. St. Mary's at 19-4, 6-3 in the West Coast Conference. But since losing their star guy, Patty Mills, they've dropped three out of four, including the first meeting of the year with Gonzaga a couple of weeks ago, 69-62. Downs to his right. Nice touch.
And good find, and again, the use of the jump hook. St. Mary's will want to get the ball into the high post area. They can screen. Oh, lazy pass again on the perimeter.
And Pargo with the pick. And can't finish it off. A blown opportunity. Hunter into the paint. And that little floater is tipped out of bounds.
We've seen a number of lazy passes, casual passes, not crisp, no ping on the ball. And then a good job of Pargo there getting that windshield wiper, that arm extended to pick it off, but just can't finish the wide open bunny.
It's 6-2. Pargo did not get up high enough. So St. Mary's will bring Carlin Hughes, 6'2 senior, back on.
Well, I think Pargo was somewhere in between. Not sure if he wanted to jam it or put it off the glass. You got to go one or the other, either John Havlicek, Jerry Lucas style, just put it old school off the window or jam it home. Can't be in between.
The fake by O'Leary to get himself wide open. Got an excellent look, but can't connect. So Gonzaga with the basketball here. Trailing. Again, 8-0 in the West Coast Conference, these guys. Bolden pulling his way in. He'll be fouled. And go to the line to shoot two. College basketball's rivalry week continues on ESPN this Saturday at noon Eastern. Georgetown and Syracuse, what a great rivalry that has been. Going back to the very early days of the Big East. And then at 9 Eastern, Saturday night primetime, Ohio State and Wisconsin into the heart of the Big Ten.
Georgetown, Syracuse, Wisconsin, they're example of teams that are bloody but unbowed. Still dangerous coming out of tough conferences, competitive leagues, and you start to look at teams.
Five Aussies on the roster here for St. Mary's. Here's a foul with 12:56 to go. The St. Mary Gales have five players from Australia. Their friends and family can keep up with all their action on ESPN Pac Rim and ESPN Australia HD. And it says here on the card, I am to say good day to you. And so I have.
No Foster's beer spots? That's coming later.
Also want to get a look at your fine restaurants, your favorite picks in San Francisco, which is home to you. You know them all, and they know you well. McConnell on the drive. Blocked away by Foster. So the seven-footer swats one and keeps it in play.
There's the Foster we were waiting on.
12:34 remaining.
That's a tall boy. A tall boy Foster. Dave, going back to the bloody but unbowed, I'll give you an example. 1997, Arizona. They go into the NCAA tournament 19-9. They finished 11-7 in the Pac-10, fifth place. They beat three number one seeds, cut down the nets, Lute Olson's national championship team. That's an example of a bloody but unbowed team. And they lost to Cal and Stanford on the last weekend of play in the Pac-10. So you don't have to panic. Some of these teams or programs that have, you know, 8-9 losses, if you're improving and you're learning from, you could still be dangerous and make deep runs in the tournament.
And St. Mary's with four losses.
Well, Gonzaga's been beat up.
And they have, indeed.
Played a tough schedule.
Brutal schedule early. Lost that double overtime game to Connecticut. Lost that game to Arizona, to Portland State and Utah. After a great start in December. Here's O'Leary with a pull-up pop. Rebounded away on a baseline by Austin Day. Zags trying to push it a bit. You can certainly do that with Pargo. Foster draws the double team. Day is open. He'll fire it up. That's too strong.
And the hesitation there. Hesitated on the first look. When in doubt, probably better to pass it. Great anticipation by Bolden. Flying a jet. The finish, a chance to go to the line for an old-fashioned three-point play. And once again, Dave, those long passes around the horn, there's distance between passer and receiver. And like a defensive back, Bolden just laying on it.
Timeout tied at 49. Zags trying to grab the lead. Question about Gonzaga is, what about March? What does that have in store? Where do they fit in when we return?
SportsCenter right now. Notre Dame loses of seven straight, hosting seventh-ranked Louisville. And Luke Herangode goes off. 32 points, 17 rebounds. The Irish pound Louisville, 90-57. Other Big East news. UConn, the number one team in the nation. They've won 12 in a row, but they lose their second-leading scorer, Jerome Dyson, for the season with a knee injury. Next SportsCenter, 10:20 Pacific time. Dave and Steve.
Brian, thanks, and thanks for staying up late with us as well. We are tied at 49 here at St. Mary's and Heidfeld and Gonzaga. Well, let's take a look at their tournament resume. And Lav, right now, how does it look for the Zags?
Well, the Zags just have to be sure they don't trip up. They need to win out in West Coast Conference regular season play and in their postseason tournament. And with the quality teams they've played, surprised that strength of schedule is as low as it is, because when you look at the teams they played, it's really a quality group. They've been tested, a rugged schedule. I think a 5 or 6 seed is reasonable, and they'd be a dangerous 5 or 6 seed. This is as talented a team. They haven't found their rhythm or stride. They've lacked chemistry and consistency this year, but still not a team you'd want to face in the first round of the NCAA tournament.
St. Mary's with the basketball here, dead even at 49. Shot clock inside 10 seconds. Mickey O'Connell on the drive. Gives it up to Hughes. Shot clock down to 3. One hands with the scoop shot. And Bolden has a head start. But Bolden undaunted into the paint. Another strong move. He is very, very tough in traffic.
Well, the intelligence there to use his body, trying to draw the foul, but also able to create space and a good look there. Kind of wedged his way in transition between two St. Mary defenders.
So we've had 12 lead changes. The game has changed hands 9 times. In terms of that lead, here's Pargo now for Gonzaga. Foster setting the screen. He weaves his way in, and he will take a foul here, hit by Ben Allen. Crowd didn't like that call at all.
One of the dangers of over-penetration and poor spacing is you see four Gales along the baseline, and there isn't the safety which allows Bolden to boat Sean Prince, and someday could have a game similar to him. He's going to have to put on some weight. He's going to have to improve his overall strength and then sustain his effort, his concentration, his intensity over the course of the game.
A day with good bloodlines. Of course, his dad played at UCLA.
One of great Bruins, played from Larry Brown, that Final Four team in the early 80s.
Here's Hunter up top. He'll swish it home. Both sides starting to go downtown.
Oh, an emerging star in Hunter, and a good strip by the Gales.
Fargo jumped up calling for a foul. Here's Hughes off the fake. Yes!
Well, it is raining threes in Moraga.
Timeout. Patty Mills loves it.
Creates daylight, and he lets it go. Torching the Nets.
St. Mary's by 2. But for one night, the Stars and Legends take the court together. Dominic Wilkins, Clyde Drexler, and others with the NBA All-Star Celebrity Game on ESPN Friday at 7.
And Julius Irving, the doctor, will be in the house coaching one of those celebrity teams.
Well, the good doctor known for his spectacular dunks, but this game has turned into a 3-point shooting contest.
Well, again, if you're Randy Bennett, you're searching and probing, using your ingenuity back in the fold by conference tournament, you could take it up a level.
Well, move forward, but they're moving back beyond that line. They're hitting 9 out of 16 tonight from 3-point distance. Shot clock down to 9 for Gonzaga. Pargo handling the ball. Dumps the pass off, slammed in by Day.
Well, Pargo, with the use of the bounce of the dribble, draws the defenders in the back line, and an excellent give up. Little shovel pass to Day with the finish.
Well, in a small gym here, it is really heated up. Sam Hand, difficult shot there along that baseline. May have forced it.
A rough night for Sam Hand.
Bolden spins, cuts through everybody for 2. He's become the man for the Zags here in the second half.
It's interesting. He's quick. He doesn't have blinding speed, but he's quick in a functional or practical way. Can get to the basket, no wasted dribbles, finds openings. Just a very high-level IQ as a basketball player.
18 points to lead all scorers for Matt Bolden. Timeout here.
Well, a talented mop top as we take a look at Matt Bolden. Probing, playing at pace, no rush, stutter step, the little pirouette like Baryshnikov. Money. Timeout.
ESPN's exclusive.
Steve Levin right there, 7 rebounds away from 1,000. He has blown right past it. Here's Hunter trying to get going again. Left that one short. Sam Hand picking off the rebound, however. Steigel will let fly. That barely glanced that rim. Eichfeld into the corner, chases it down, and the Zags have it.
Important that Gonzaga, just as I was going to say, they get a good look at the basket, and they throw one away. Just a miscommunication between passer and receiver. Seems like a simple fundamental, but you need to have eye contact, see a target hand. Fargo knows better. I always felt it's on the passer to hold up on that. Don't force until you see a target hand or some recognition. There's Sam Hand.
Over the head of Austin Day for two.
Well, a quiet night for the big fella, but the easy finish there at 6'11".
Averaging 13 points per game, so well off that, but still plenty of time.
And they have the early foul trouble. Sometimes you just face teams where it's not a good matchup defensively. Doesn't have the lateral foot speed, and the Zags clearly have the edge there in terms of quickness.
Day, last shot over the head of Simpson. St. Mary's comes away with the rock here. Harlan Hughes running the point. The senior may have, if he had another chance, gone right down the lane with that, but decided to pass off. Eichfeld dishes down low, and Day with the slam.
A good decision in the break by Eichfeld to give up the ball. And again, Day at 6'10 runs the break, gets himself in the basket area, and finishes.
So Gonzaga up by two, 5:40 left. Steindl, the freshman. Another man from Australia.
We've seen both teams' turnovers cost them. And there's another one. You know, it allows teams to get out in the break, get easy baskets. We talked about the boat racing factor.
Gray nearly lost it, and he did. That one rolled off his fingertips.
Well, good tenacity there, staying after it. There's the unnecessary shovel pass. It's picked off. Leads to the break, the give up by Pargo, the quick touch pass by Eichfeld. And Day is going to stretch out. Long 6'10.
He's real solid in Gonzaga's win over St. Mary's at the end of January. 10 points, 9 rebounds, 4 blocks. And Alon High going into that lane. The kick out, here's Hughes. And finally, someone missed a three. Another chance, though, for St. Mary's, and they throw it away. You're right about turnovers. They're becoming critical on both sides.
You can open a bakery here tonight with the number of turnovers.
Eichel, quick move, and he's fouled.
And that last,
Sam Hand.
Dave, that last pass was an example, again, of what I call passing in the closet or passing in tight quarters. There's just not the good spacing. The intention for Sam Hand to look to his comrade down low is a good one. But when you're at the mid post trying to feed the low post, there's just not the space or distance there for accurate passing.
On this team, it's not comrade, it's mate.
That's right. It is a tight group.
Sam Hand's fourth foul, by the way.
Well, again, we're going to see the offensive rebound by Sam Hand, and just not a lot of space. And again, Day able to get those hands extended like a big oak tree. The tentacles, like an octopus, and steal that pass.
Again, 4 personals for him.
I'm trying to paint as many pictures as I can for an octopus, oak tree, extended
long. Do it beautifully. 64-60. Came up in a very creative family. With wonderful parents, I might add. Got a chance to have a Great dinner with them last night in San Francisco.
Yeah, and they were thrilled with you.
Well, I've put another one over on another great couple, I can tell you that.
It's that Irish charm.
Hughes zips the pass out. Walker gives it up. Shot clock down to five. They've got a hustle. Here's Hughes around and out. Heitfeld with the board. He's really having a terrific ball game.
That's a good look. If you're Randy Bennett, you don't mind that.
Bolden. Oh, net from Matt Bolden. He strikes again.
And you do mind that, Dave. No excuse for that. Defensively, the quick timeout by Randy Bennett. Need to scramble back if you're the Gales. Find people with a sense of urgency. Communicate, point, talk it out, and get to the shooter. And in particular, it's inexcusable because the hot hand is the one wide open. How do you miss him? Take a look here. The feed up the floor.
Big foul shots in the final minute. Brett Collins scored 8 straight points to Keane. It's a 2-run late. And they wind up winning it by a final score of 89-81. A Cisco game track. 7-point lead for Gonzaga, their biggest of the game.
Well, when you look at the program that's been built here at St. Mary's by Randy Bennett, the architect, you look at who shaped him, the influences. He's had many. His father was an outstanding junior college coach in Arizona at Mesa Community College, but also had stops at San Diego. He worked for Hank Egan, worked for Lorenzo Romar at St. Louis and Pepperdine. So a number of great mentors, paid his dues, you know, similar to Bruce Weber, one of the West Coast Conference.
Bruce, who was there for so long under Gene Katie at Purdue, day in the paint, leaves his shot to pluck it away. Now does Gonzaga run a little bit of clock here, leading by 7, coming up on 3 minutes. Bolden gives it up to Pargo off the fake, wants to get a little bit closer, pulls his way in, no foul, Bolden, no, from 3. And Simpson with the rebound. St. Mary's led by 9 in the first half. And Bennett will take a timeout. Timeout St. Mary's with 2:45 to go. Bidding for the 20th win of the season.
You know, going back to Randy Bennett, just revisiting that, Dave. An outstanding reputation and similar to Bruce Weber as a longtime loyal. Sears led Santa Clara to a Final Four. And of course, under Phil Wolpert, 60 consecutive wins, back-to-back national titles during the Bill Russell, Casey Jones era. And then Steve Nash at Santa Clara with Dick Davey had that nice run in the mid-90s. St. Mary's under Ernie Kent and Lynn Nance made appearances in the NCAA tournament. And
great, great basketball out here. By the way, happy birthday wishes to Bill Russell, number 75.
Well, and most recently, speaking of the West Coast Conference, Mark Few has had a dynamic run. It all started with Dan Munson, who then turned it over, passed the baton to a longtime assistant at Gonzaga, and Coach Few has elevated really the gold standard of the West Coast Conference to another level.
Well, in doing it again tonight, this game was dead even at halftime. And now Gonzaga threatening to pull away. Heitfeld with 18, also 10 rebounds. But on the other side, Diamond Simpson with 12 points and 15 rebounds. NASCAR now coming up next as soon as we wrap it up here from the campus of St. Mary's.
And you never know. Gonzaga may just be getting ready to round into form, Dave. They may be getting ready to close out conference with momentum in February and March.
Well, they stepped out of conference, their annual matchup with Memphis, and took it on the chin. They played pretty well here tonight.
But considering it's a road game in particular, good swarm in the post, like bees on honey, alertly covering down on Diamond Simpson.
And Gonzaga takes it away.
That's a great smother on the post.
Gonzaga with 11 steals, and Steve, 8 of them in the second half. A huge reason they are in the lead here. Coming up on 2 minutes to go. Pargo jumping in the lane, swatted away by Samham.
And staff, when you don't have a Patty Mills, leading scorer, leading playmaker, the one that's got the swagger, the confidence to take a game over, it is so tough when you lose someone like that in mid-season. It's one thing when you have a player graduate, you have a full off-season and non-conference games to kind of adjust or retool with a new group. But so difficult in mid-stride once the ship has left port.
And your point well made, too. It's beyond points with Mills. It is 19 points a game. He's a terrific passer. He's their best foul shooter, but he's their heart and soul.
Everything is just more difficult. And a big part of their attack is ball screens. He comes off ball screens as well as any point guard in the country.
Golden running some clock around the back. Here's Day. That could have been a Gonzaga with 11 steals, and Steve, 8 of them in the second half. A huge reason they are in the lead here. Coming up on 2 minutes to go. Fargo jumping in the lane, swatted away by Samham. And Bill Russell Light kept it in play.
Good observation there.
Steindl straight on. Nothing but air. It looked pretty good coming off his hand, but he didn't touch anything.
And Dave, this is the tough stretch of the game for the Gales. They've given a valiant effort, an admirable effort, well-devised game plan and schemes by Randy Bennett and the staff, but when you don't have a Patty Mills, leading scorer, leading playmaker, the one that's got the swagger, the confidence to take a game over, it is so tough when you lose someone like that in mid-season. It's one thing when you have a player graduate, you have a full off-season and non-conference games to kind of adjust or retool with a new group. But so difficult in mid-stride once the ship is left port.
And your point well made, too. It's beyond points with Mills. It is 19 points a game. He's a terrific passer. He's their best foul shooter, but he's their heart and soul.
Everything is just more difficult. And a big part of their attack is ball screens. He comes off ball screens as well as any point guard in the country.
Golden running some clock around the back. Here's Day. That could have been a dagger. A minute 22 left. That one stripped away by Wayne Hunter. He wants to do it down the lane. And another timeout by Randy Bennett. Timeout St. Mary's. 1:17 to go. They're still in it.
And ball security once again haunting both these teams. Empty possessions. If there's been a real positive for St. Mary's, it's the emergence of Hunter.
Well, Heitfeld has emerged big time in this one. The senior out of Clarkston, Washington. He has been hammering away at that glass tonight and scoring as well. He's pretty much done it all. Bolden has 21 points, but Heitfeld with 18 points, 10 rebounds, and he's also made 9 of 10 foul shots.
And if the big fellas playing with confidence and putting up productive numbers, that bodes well for the Zags as they try and find their stride and peak at the right time of the year coming down the stretch.
Heitfeld came in averaging 14 and 7. Gonzaga with the basketball here. St. Mary's has the possession arrow.
Patty Mills encouraging the fans to get off their fannies here at McKeon.
But it has a sad tone to it because he's got that big cast on that hand.
It is heartbreaking if you're a St. Mary's fan.
Gonzaga trying to break the press. Downs does with a pass to Bolden. Bolden at 74% at the line.
Let's take a look at late game execution, understanding time and score. Want to get a good look at the basket.
Downs, their best foul shooter. Here's a foul of 55.9 seconds, and it'll be Day to go to shoot.
And I like that, Dave. Spread the floor, three out. Put your two big men along the baseline, the short corners or the shadows of the baseline. Get that penetration. You get the help uphill, and now you dump it down or you throw it over the top to the rim to your big.
Walker with the foul. Day's 72% at the free throw line. Seven points tonight.
Well, his production in the second half has been key for the Zagas. Like the fact he takes his time on the free throw. Gets good flexion in the knees. Got a buttery or soft touch. Spent a lot of time in the gym with his father over the years honing those skills.
NASCAR now coming up when we finish up here at St. Mary's. At 9 Eastern on ESPN, it'll be Ohio State and Wisconsin. I say Georgetown Syracuse always a great matchup. It wasn't the last time they played.
Well, of course, you're a Syracuse grad, so you have a vested interest there. So you watch the Orange. Just revisiting the assistants. Ray Giacoletti was a head coach, Dave, at Eastern Washington, Utah, now on the staff. What an advantage to be able to see on your bench someone who's been there before as a head coach, and you see him lean on Ray Jacoletti as an advisor. Tommy Lloyd, a very capable assistant as well. And, of course, Leon Rice, a longtime Gonzaga assistant.
Bolden thought about a baseball pass into Heitfeld, and they go and foul Josh Heitfeld. 72% foul shooter, 1-1. That they run about every 3 years, and they hardly ever won it, but several games ago, out of a timeout, St. Mary's decided to run that play, and the moment that they set up in that formation, Mark Few started screaming out to his kids, chin, chin, chin. That's the play that they were running. They'd run it like once in 5 years.
Sounds like a little Bill Belichick with the Patriots. Yeah. They may have to start looking to see if there's a hidden camera there, a little spygate in the West Coast Conference.
Oh, they are so well prepared. That one rolls off by Heitfeld.
Even Jerry Krause, the director of basketball operations in his eighth year, Dave. So long continuity of ties to this program.
The swing up top for Hughes. He needed a
point attack. Has been effective. The quick hot potato, the extra pass, Pargo with the closeout, but not there in time. Shredding the nets. The Gales won't go away. Pesky. No.
And
spirited.
Hughes, by the way, is taking more threes than anybody on a team other than Mills, but he only hits 31%. But he picked a big moment to knock one down. Trying to get it done without Patty Mills here.
Well, look at that point shooting. You got to give it up to the Gale force as well. The student section here, they've brought it from start to finish. Sustained effort. Sixth man, the crowd.
Gonzaga has been the top dog in the WCC for so long and leading the league right now at 8-0.
Dave, right now, if you're St. Mary's, you're going to try and get the steal off the inbounds. You can go for a quick trap somewhere in the backcourt. You can even try for a 10-second violation, but the minute they get over half court, they have to foul. But they may elect just to go ahead and shorten the game, lengthen the game if you're St. Mary's, and go right now for the foul.
Now Gonzaga with the basketball here. We reset again. St. Mary's out of timeouts. Mark Few has one.
Looks like St. Mary's going to take a man off the ball, let him play center field, try and double the cutters coming to the ball in the full court press.
They trust Bolden with the inbounds. Over the top to Heitfeld.
There it is.
Exactly 30 seconds left and a three-point lead for Gonzaga. 1-1 time.
And I like that look, Dave. They tried to get the five-second violation on the inbound. They go for the steal. They don't get it. Foul right now. Good clock management. Still 30 seconds to go in the game. And now you put some game pressure on Heitfeld as he steps to the line.
It's not like you've got 4,000 students waving in your face. So a slight advantage, and Heitfeld takes advantage of that.
A cool customer on his first free throw.
Left the second one well short.
But take it to the hole. Does not have to be a three. It's a two-possession game. We're a stop clock.
Hughes gave up his dribble now. Takes it back. He hit that 3 moments ago. Out for Walker. Short. Steindl. Hughes.
Yes! He banked it in! He banked it in!
And no foul call, Dave.
Nine seconds remaining here. Let's take a look. Should there have been a foul call?
A little shot fake gets Heitfeld in the air, but a no call.
He banks in the three and no whistle. Heitfeld kind of leaning back out of the way. But a circus shot by the Australian Carlin Hughes.
Well, once Heitfeld gets airborne, he's vulnerable. But no whistle, a swallow of the whistle on your home floor. And Randy Bennett said, I can't get a call on my home court.
Gonzaga by one. 9.9 seconds remaining. Bolden already to the line. What a finish here. Bolden 74%. He's had a big scoring night with 21. They added some time, so it's at 9.9 seconds. They've added 8 tenths, and he misses the first one. Take a look. No whistle, a line drive bank shot, so they add that time.
And plenty of time, Dave, with 9 seconds to push the ball, probe, or look to get to the rim.
In and out.
1 point game, you want to go to the rim.
No timeouts remaining, and a foul by Pargo at midcourt.
Wow.
They had a foul to give there. 3.3 seconds left.
Well, a good foul to stop the head of steam off the bounce.
Well, a perfect game in the midst of rivalry week, huh, here in the West Coast Conference. 3.3 seconds left. Gonzaga clinging to a 1 point lead.
And I'm impressed with both teams for different reasons. It's been sloppy offensively, a lot of turnovers. Some of that is nerves and the rivalry. But when you consider that Gonzaga's coming off the Memphis loss, I think their response has been good tonight. And St. Mary's down their best player, Patty Mills, has been up to the challenge. So both coaches can feel good about where their teams are in terms of responding to adversity.
The officials are taking a look at the monitor to determine what time should be on the clock as they go back to the point of the foul. So that's what they're glancing at as Pargo raced in on Hughes and fouled him.
And the big challenge there is not picking up the intentional foul, but because he went after the ball and exaggerated, emphasized the fact he was reaching for the ball. Oftentimes players will make a mistake and they'll just whack you and you get the intentional.
They're going to add about 3 seconds here, or close to it.
Well, and that's important because it gives you more time to probe with the bounce. You can also run a quick screening action, a screen the screener, a ball screen. You can look for a high low, so there's more options at Randy Bennett's disposal as he works over there in the timeout with the Gales.
St. Mary's with the basketball, 6.2 seconds remaining. And trying to hang Gonzaga with their first loss in the West Coast Conference. Wayne Hunter looking to inbound here. Now an official timeout. And they're going to back off Day a little bit. They're going to warn him.
Well, with Day's height, there's a clear advantage there. He needs to give space.
He's 6'11".
Now I would imagine Hughes or Simpson, but there's the possibility.
3 point Gonzaga lead. It's two. Sam Hamill the rebound. 2 seconds left. Hughes casts it up. And Gonzaga hangs on to win it. And they remain perfect inside the West Coast Conference. Now 9-0. Matt Bolden, our Sonic player of the game with 21 points. He got hot about midway through the first half, Lav, and he kept on hitting them.
Well, he was up there on our star watch for the right reason. An excellent playmaker, a shot maker, has the confidence. He quarterbacks this Gonzaga team and has unusual poise and composure. The son of a coach understands the game.
Well, it winds up being a terrific finish. Gonzaga and Mark Few will march out of Northern California with a win here tonight, but hard fought, 72 to 72.